Gemini is here. It's the newest release from the EndeavorOS team and is packed with exciting updates and improvements. Named after NASA's Gemini program, which bridged the gap between the Mercury and Apollo missions, this release represents a significant step forward for the project. So, let's break it down. Gemini introduces several key features and fixes that enhance the overall user experience. First off, the highlight of Gemini is the inclusion of Plasma 6 and Qt 6. These are the latest version of the Plasma desktop environment and Qt framework, respectively. They bring a host of improvements and new features to the table, making your computing experience smoother and more enjoyable. With Gemini, you have the flexibility to choose between Wayland and X11 for your display server. Wayland is the default option for offline installation, but you can still opt for X11 if needed. This ensures compatibility with a wide range of hardware configurations, giving you the best possible experience on your system. They switch from NVIDIA DKMS to NVIDIA packages in Gemini. This change was made to address issues that some users were experiencing, such as freezing in the live environment when using NVIDIA graphics. The new NVIDIA packages provide a more stable and reliable experience for NVIDIA users. In this release, they decided to remove the ARM installation option. While they're still open to collaboration for anyone interested in working on the ARM project, they felt it was best to focus their efforts elsewhere for the time being. Gemini includes a fix for a bug that caused EFI partition not to be created correctly when the replace partition option was chosen during installation. This ensures a smoother installation process for users who prefer to customize their partition layout. They brought Gparted back to the ISO alongside KDE Partition Manager. This decision was made based on feedback from users who felt that Gparted offered additional features and functionality that were missing in KDE Partition Manager. Having both options available gives users more flexibility when managing their disk partitions. For users who prefer the GNOME desktop environment, they made a small but important change. Their native Welcome Updater and EOS Bash Shared now use the GNOME terminal by default when GNOME is chosen as the desktop environment. This resolves an issue where the terminal windows couldn't be closed, providing a smoother experience for GNOME users. In Gemini, they've made the decision to remove the EOS Update Notifier from the default installation list. While it can still be installed as an option through their Welcome app after installation, they felt that removing it by default would streamline the installation process and reduce clutter for users who prefer not to use it. In addition to the changes listed above, Gemini also brings several enhancements to their native apps and libraries. Here's what you can expect. EOS Update. Their update tool now includes new options and provides more information with the command EOS update-help. They also fixed issues related to running it in a CRUD environment, making it more reliable and robust. NVIDIA Inst. This tool now supports installing non-DKMS NVIDIA drivers, giving users more flexibility when setting up their NVIDIA graphics card. EOS Sendlog. They added support for URL expiration with services like OXO, as well as a warning about sending sensitive data. Additionally, they fixed the issues related to running it through SSH and added experimental support for DAS command. Overall, Gemini represents a significant milestone for EndeavorOS. With Plasma 6, Qt 6, and a host of other improvements, this is the most polished release yet. And as always, if you find this video useful, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you for joining me, and I'll see you on the next one.